Throughout life, we are faced with challenges. Challenges that might be as basic as learning how to tie a shoe. It can also be something as painful as losing a family member. These challenges can sometimes make you wonder, this is a challenge to me, and what have I really gone through in life? Or they can be so challenging that they can almost tear family apart. For most people, they would rather choose the less challenging one, but the people I would consider more advanced would choose the more challenging path. I say this because when people are faced with challenges, they are also faced with opportunity. I mean, think about it. Say you're met with a situation where you have to choose something as small as spicy or regular mustard on a sandwich. Although it's something as small as that, you're still left with the opportunity to know how to build your perfect sandwich. What I'm attempting to get at is that everything that happens in life is an opportunity to learn. We need to stop taking that for granted. Going into high school, many people just look at it as more school and a new but unwanted start. We're all happy with the friends we had and the ways we spent our free time, but when we get to high school, everything we know could take a complete 180 and change who you are entirely. Some embrace it and some choose to wait as long as possible. I chose to embrace it. Although I chose to embrace the change, like everything in life, it came with consequences. Many classmates who I had been friends with since elementary school chose to take different paths than I. They did not care to embrace it, and in all honesty, if I could go back today and do it all over again, I would go back and take this path less traveled and had gone with them. Although I have very much enjoyed everyone I have met over my high school career, a lot of times I wish I would have stuck with them. Throughout my entire time here, I have gone through different friend groups, changing almost as often as grading periods. This is why I wish I had stayed with my old friends. While I was in and out of groups, they were always together, covering each other's backs. They always had each other to fall back on, and always knew that when they needed something, one of them would be there no matter what. You do not think about this often until you haven't either seen it happen or had something where you needed help but did not have anyone to help you out. It's a terrible feeling being in between friends, having no more than one or two people who would always be there for you through thick and thin. Those people are the ones you can always count on, and for me, those were my friends Kip and Andrew. Around the end of sophomore year, I was hanging out with the wrong group of people, and they knew it and told me, but I was too ignorant to accept it, and they just let me do what I wanted but never let me too far away from them. They were always there for me, and for this I can never thank them enough. I like to say they saved my entire high school life. At the end of my junior year, the people I had been hanging around with were all older than me, and little did I know they were the wrong group of people to be around. I had no clue, but two of the people that were in the small group were into drugs. Serious drugs. At nearly the end of the year, we had all been going to school and seeing each other, but one person never showed up. It went on for a week until we found out. One of our older friends had been caught doing heroin, and that moment, I can say all of our hearts skipped a beat. None of us would have ever guessed that the person close to us could do such a thing and never have us even notice. It's crazy what people can get away with. Shortly after this, we found out another one had the same problem. They had been sent to rehab, and when we found out the second time, I knew it was time for me to move on, but I was worried about where I would go. I stuck with the same people or at my house alone until one day I got the text I like to say saved my life. In a group text from Kip and Andrew, completely random, I got the two words that mean most to me now and until the day I die. Lake Day came up on my screen, and at first, a little uncertain, I let it sit. 2 minutes later, I got another text saying, "We'll teach you how to wakeboard." Against my instincts of hating cold water, I replied, "Why not?" Shortly after, they were at my house, and then we were on the boat, in the water, getting ready to take our first run. I went first. I got up on my very first try, and at that moment, I knew that wakeboarding with my friends was greater than anything else I could ever possibly do. Ever since then, wakeboarding has been Kip, Andrew, and I's source of everything. Anytime we have a chance or free time, you'll find two of us on the boat and one of us in the water with GoPros recording all the fun.